De enige echte Corey Taylor van Slipknot hier naast mij. Ik ben een beetje bang. Hi Corey, it's so good to see you again.
Oh, it's all good. How are you doing?
I am fine. It's your sixth time at Grasspop with Slipknot.
Yeah.
Do you have any special Grasspop memories?
I love this place. You know, like the cool thing about Grasspop is where I got to meet for the first time, like a lot of my heroes, you know, like this was the place where I first met Alice Cooper. This was the place where I first met Ronnie James Dio. I first met Udo Dirkschneider here. Like, it's just such a great festival. You know, there's so many great bands, so many wonderful fans that, I mean, it's one of those things when we see it on the list, we're like, oh, we're playing Grasspop, yes! So we get very, very excited.
So did you meet Alice Cooper again today?
I tried to, yeah. A friend of mine actually plays guitar in his band. So we got to see them. We got to see them play, but they left like right after, so I didn't get to see him and say hi. But he knows my name, which is crazy. You know, like that messes with my head.
You can exchange like tips about the makeup
and golf. You know, we can exchange some golf tips because I don't play, but he does. You know.
Oh really? Okay.
Yeah.
You know, you're universally you're praised as one of the best vocalists. And they say you have a range of 5.5 octaves.
Yeah, I never kept track, to be honest, and I'm glad somebody did because I didn't know that.
But
you know?
Can you show me?
No.
Come on.
We've been here for 3 weeks. My voice is so shot. Like, I have no idea if it's even going to work tonight, to be honest. I'm like, oh God. So.
Really? Are you worried about that sometimes?
Yeah, sometimes. You know, it's when you do like so many shows in a row. It starts to kind of, you know, just kind of kick your butt. But, you know, hopefully, you know, once it's time, you know, the adrenaline kicks in and you start getting weird. It usually comes back. So we'll see what happens.
But, you know, there's one man on the bill who can do 6 octaves.
Rob Halford. Oh, yeah.
No.
Oh, Mike Patton.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. He's amazing. He's like... He's one of my heroes too, man. You know, he's such a great guy. He's an amazing singer. I mean, pitch perfect. You just look at him, you go, why are you that good? Stop being that damn good, you know? So it's pretty rad.
Yeah, I read that you saw him live lately and that you were very impressed.
I was blown away. Like, yeah. I mean, it was on their first reunion tour.
Yeah.
And when they opened with Reunited, and it was so smooth, and he comes out, he's in this red suit, and I'm like, oh, are you kidding? That's like the coolest thing I've ever seen.
But
so
it's only a half an octave of a difference, so maybe you can beat him.
I doubt it. I smoke way too many cigarettes, so I'm not trying to do that.
Okay. Yesterday I had a chat with Gene Simmons from Kiss, and he said that the last 20 years there weren't any iconic rock acts. There weren't any born. Do you agree?
Oh, hell no. No. Come on. Korn, us, you know? I mean, there's a bunch of damn... That's, well, 20 years. Christ, Pearl Jam's still doing it. Mm-hmm. I mean, yeah, of course there are, you know?
But can Slipknot be like the Kiss of this generation? Like this incredible live act, like a cult band?
Maybe, you know? I mean, we don't have as many products... As Kiss does, you know.
Yes, 2000.
I know. He loves to show them. You know, with all due respect to Mr. Simmons, mm-hmm. I kindly disagree. You know, I mean, this is the same guy who said that rock is dead. And look at all those crazy people outside, you know. If we're dead, where are you? Really? Where'd you check for a pulse? On the knee? You know, you check on the neck or on the wrist, you know. We're very much alive.
That's what I call a statement.
You're damn right it's a statement.
Okay, but bigger productions and bigger shows, I can imagine it gives you a lot of stress because of the timings and the videos. Do you have a lot of freedom on stage?
Oh, yeah, absolutely, yeah. I mean, you just don't go where the fire is,
okay.
You know. That's really the only rule you need. It's like, okay, fire there, fire bad, fire hot, fire burn, go owie.
You know exactly what's happening?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. You have to be aware, you know?
Okay.
I mean, you can be in the moment and everything and you can go crazy, but you just, over the years, you just develop that kind of, not a sixth sense, but like an instinct, you know? Okay. you know where everything's going to happen, you know where everything's going to be, and you just work your way around it. You know, you do your thing, but yet you have to be safe, you know? I mean, we're not 25 anymore, man. There's no way that we could do half the stuff that we used to do. So just know where the fire is, know where Clown is throwing his kegs. That's very important. He almost broke my thumb the other night. That was very funny. It was a flashback. I was like, you jerk. So I threw my mic at him. Like, it was a whole thing. But now we're fine.
Okay.
We're all good now.
Okay. You also write books. And your last book, You're Making Me Hate You, you take on popular culture. So how do you divide quality from rubbish?
It's quite easy, to be honest. I mean, you can smell rubbish. You know, quality is few and far between, to be honest. It's just out there, you know? I mean, when Kim Kardashian is more famous than the scientist who landed a spaceship on a comet, there's a fucking issue there, okay? But that's just me. I'm an asshole, you know?
That's another statement.
Yeah, it's quite.
You're a dad yourself.
Yeah, I am. Yeah.
What would happen if you walk into your daughter or son's room and they're dancing and singing to Justin Bieber?
I'd close the door behind me. That's really all you can do, you know? I mean, the thing with my kids is I encourage them to be themselves, you know? And if that's what they're into, fine, that's cool. My son is into weird stuff, man. Like, he's on YouTube all the time. He's looking up, like, all these Japanese, like hip-hop bands that I've never even heard of. And I'm just like, where did you find that? And he's just like, dude, and he can dance. He can really dance. So there's a part of me that's very proud that he can, you know, he's got that skill. And then there's the other part of me that's just like, what the hell are you listening to? Like, I mean, it's just, you know, it's a very dad moment, you know, where you're just kind of like, okay, that's fine. So
do they like Slipknot?
Yeah, yeah, they appreciate it. You know, my son, he loves to come and see us play. He loves some of our songs, like Psychosocial is probably his favorite, and Spit It Out. But, you know, but at the same time, he's developing his own style, you know, and that's very important. You have to pass that on. You can't force your own tastes down their throat, or they won't know, or they'll have, like, an aversion to music. So, and I don't want that.
Okay, and what if he wants to be a rocker, too?
Oh, God. Too much work, man, you know? Like, it took us... I started playing shows when I was 13. It took me 12 years just to get to the point where we were signed and everything. That's just too much work. I'm gonna make him be a lawyer.
Your touring schedule is very busy. How do you keep up with that? Do you have like special eating habits, or do you work out, or?
Yeah. I mean, I work out at home and I work out on the road when I can. But I mean, all you can do is just kind of try and take care of yourself. This is coming from the guy who smokes cigarettes and drinks coffee. Yeah, I'm a real guru when it comes to health.
But a lot of these rockers, they stop drinking, stop taking drugs. They're like all vegan.
Yeah.
Why is that?
I don't know. They probably got bored. I mean, I quit drinking. I quit everything. I'm sober. And it's, you know, okay. I still eat giant steaks and French fries and all kinds of garbage.
Okay.
But, you know, it's about staying healthy. It's about going where your mind is, not necessarily where your body is. You know, when I hit 40, I was like, oh, time to get back in shape, you know, and I just, you know, I never looked back.
Okay.
Yeah.
Never look back. That's a good advice.
Yeah. There's a lot of good statements on here. I'm just letting you know.
Okay, guys, after the tour, what comes after that? I can't imagine you guys going golfing or lying on a beach.
No. I go home and I'm a dad, you know? That's what I do. That's my vacation time, is being a dad. So a lot of cleaning up after crazy children, a lot of cooking for 40 people.
Oh, you're a good cook?
Oh, yeah. Well, I don't know if I'm a good cook. I'm a cook.
What's your best dish?
I do a really, really good lasagna. And I do it, but it's massive. It's like the size of that table. Like I make them in, you know, the aluminum pans that you can make turkeys in.
Yeah.
That's what I make that's what I make the lasagna in. So it's giant.
With ricotta cheese or with?
I use a ricotta. Okay. I use a layer of ricotta. But then the next time that comes around, I'll use cottage cheese mixed with Parmesan. So it's like totally different flavors, commingling and whatnot. And then I brown the meat in a special proprietary seasoning thing that I do. And then, you know, mix it with the sauce, and then I do the layers. And yeah, it's all good.
Sounds so good. Please invite me once.
If you're in the States, absolutely. Sure. Come on over. I'll cook for everybody.
Thanks for the interview. Have a great show tonight. I'm really looking forward to it.
I am too.
All right.
Can't wait.